Hello everyone, Not Dead Yet here, sorry for the big delay in uploads recently, life's been a little bit rough, and so kind of sorting out a lot of the stuff I have going on in my personal life has made filming and editing videos a little bit difficult for the time being. However, that is fine, that's why I'm here filming this video now, because I want to talk about something that is really important to me when it comes to the sport of boxing. So, if anybody is even remotely familiar with the sport of boxing, you will know who Anthony Joshua and Tyson Fury are. They are the two current heavyweight champions of the world, and if you follow boxing in any way, shape, or form, you will also know that these two champions were set to meet in the ring sometime this summer, allegedly around July, in Saudi Arabia. However, if you follow boxing news, you will also know that that is most likely not going to happen, thanks to a contract that Fury had signed with Deontay Wilder for their trilogy bout. For those of you that don't know, Anthony Joshua and Tyson Fury were set to fight, but right around a week or two ago, Deontay Wilder, who was the former heavyweight champ before Tyson Fury beat him, came in and said, "Hold on, we still have one more fight to do. You signed a trilogy bout with me, and we have only fought twice. You still need to fight me one more time before you can fight Anthony Joshua." And that threw everything, all the plans for the Joshua fight, for a loop, and upset a lot of people. It upset the fans, it upset Joshua and Fury themselves, and it upset the Saudi Arabian ambassador, who was working incredibly hard to get this fight to happen. And it feels like a big kick in the teeth for all involved. And the reason why I wanted to talk about this is because I believe there are three possible things that could have actually caused this situation. Number one being this whole thing is a publicity stunt, and number two being politics. But this politics part can be split into two sub-portions. So there's the unintended consequences of stupid politics, or just straight up malicious politics. I'm going to start with the publicity stunt because that's the more easy one to explain, and then I'll move on to the politics one because that's the more interesting one. That's the one I want you guys to kind of think and muse about, and hopefully that's the thing that'll get you to stay to the end of the video. So we'll start with the publicity stunt theory. Could this all be a publicity stunt? I think so. It makes somewhat sense. I mean, people have wanted a Joshua versus Fury fight for a long time. It has been in the works for a long time, and now it finally gets confirmed. Everyone's excited, and suddenly, boom, something happens, and it doesn't happen anymore. Everyone's pissed. Everyone's pissed. And if you watch the back and forth that Joshua and Fury have had on their social medias, you will see that there's a lot of animosity between the two fighters. So we get kind of a character arc and a story arc that goes along with the fight, and that is usually how great fights are marketed. If you pay attention to not just boxing, but any real fighting sport, UFC, Bellator, Judo, wrestling, whatever, some of the greatest and most memorable fights were billed with character arcs and character stories. So the first one is that the two fighters are set to fight, they're excited, everything's well, good, and kosher, but then suddenly, because Fury didn't clear up his final fight, and there were still muddy politics involved with Wilder steps in and goes, "Hey, hold on, I still have the right to fight you one more time," and then that throws the plans for a loop. Both fighters get pissed with each other. Fury and Wilder fight. Fury smashes Wilder for the third time, in my opinion, because I think he won the first fight, and then he moves on to smash and fight with Anthony Joshua, with a way more hype behind it with the fans, and also way more stakes involved with the fighters, because now allegedly both fighters hate each other. It's just your classic, let's sell this fight. And I think there could potentially, like, again, I don't know how true this is, but when I first heard the news, that was the first thing I thought of. This could be a big publicity stunt. However, I do want to draw attention to the fact that this also just could be really shitty politics, because politics is something that is riddled throughout the boxing world, and it's not something that is often talked about, and it's why there are certain forms of boxing media, Ashton O'Joe, and ironically, Rocky V, that actually touch upon the really, really shitty boxing politics of it all. I'm gonna start with the unintended consequences and then move on to the malicious consequences, because they kind of play into one another. People consider boxing to be a really complicated sport to get into. And I agree. Even myself, I never really used to like the watching boxing. For me, I always, when I was younger, I always saw boxing as kind of a job. And it's like, well, if you are a professional butcher, are you going to go home and watch videos of people taking a carcass apart? Maybe. Maybe if you love it, but to me, I was like, you know what? No, I've boxed enough for today. I'm going to go play my video games and relax with my friends because I don't have time for that. I don't have much time for that. However, as I've grew up more and got more and more invested in the sport, I wanted to learn more about the fighters in it, the history, how the sport works, the various organizations, etc., etc. And it is very complicated. There are three different championship organizations. There are various titles. There's the current champion, the lineal champion, and again, the champion in various organizations. There are a ton of weight classes, too many in my opinion, and it just feels like entering the boxing world and understanding it is like trying to enter comic books and understand it. It's like, oh, I want to learn about Spider-Man. Oh, which one? We have Miles, Ultimate, 616, post-reboot, pre-reboot, the Steve Ditko era, the 90s era, and blah, 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 blah. And it becomes incredibly complicated and difficult to follow along if you do not already know what the hell is going on. But even further than that, the politics of it are incredibly complicated because there's different organizations, outside promoters, outside managers, and all of this stuff comes together with everybody is trying to make as much money as possible. And sometimes that can come at the expense of not only the people watching, but the boxers involved. Boxers have died or lost millions of dollars to really shitty politics and really shitty promoters. If you really want a wild ride, look up Don King and read his Wikipedia page. Don King, D-O-N King, K-I-N-G, right? Don King. He has been sued by three of the greatest boxers of all time. If memory serves, it's Mike Tyson, Muhammad Ali, and I think Sugar Ray Leonard. Correct me if I'm wrong. I'm a little bit fuzzy on that, but yeah, he is the textbook example of a shitty promoter, and he is everywhere throughout boxing media. He's the black guy with the suit, hair with like the white stripes, and he kind of talks like this. He's really fast, and he's a great speaker. That's Don King. But the point is that boxing is a sport riddled with ego and politics, and everyone is essentially trying to screw each other over in order to make the most amount of money. And if we take this on a purely innocent standpoint, this Deontay Wilder needing to fight Tyson Fury a third time is just simply the result of the overcomplicated nature of the sport, and how with all these promoters and all these contracts and all these different divisions, weight classes, belts, and organizations, how things can get so muddied and confusing that it becomes incredibly difficult to schedule big name super fights. Unlike something like the UFC, where they have all their fighters under one organization, one branch with one promoter, and then each fighter has their own manager and whatever. It's a lot easier to schedule these massive super fights that fans want to see, because it's pretty much everybody under one singular roof. However, in boxing, there's a bunch of little roofs that are trying to make their roof slightly bigger, screwing everybody over. And if we look at it innocently, Deontay Wilder coming in to kind of mess with the Joshua Fury fight is just an unintended consequence of that. However, and I think the more likely version of this is Deontay Wilder coming in and maliciously and intentionally screwing up and screwing with the Joshua fight because he can. He realizes, or his promoter realizes how muddy and messed up and confusing the politics of boxing is, and they're using that to their advantage. They're taking what is in what they're taking the innocent theory that we just proposed and using it to their advantage to get Wilder a leg up. Because if Wilder wins that fight, he becomes heavyweight champ again, and that completely screws up the match between Fury and Joshua, because it's no longer, they were billing it as the two heavyweight champions, and it's no longer the two heavyweight champions, and then I believe it would be Wilder who has the right to fight Joshua, not Fury, which again screws everything up. So it's these little camps that are working and using these intentionally confusing and muddy watered politics to screw each other over and come out on top. And who loses ultimately? The fans. It's like The fighters certainly lose to an extent. Depending on how things play out, things like their purse, their health, and just their reputations can be affected. And I'm sure, but just if you follow Tyson Fury, you will know that he is really invested in fighting. Sure, I'm sure he loves the money, but it's clear to him that fighting is his life. If you follow what he says, and you follow him through his kind of depression story where he was an alcoholic, addicted to drugs and everything, boxing saved his life, and he just loves to fight. I'm pretty sure he's been diagnosed with clinical depression, and when he doesn't have a fight, his life is meaningless. When he is training for a fight and he is going to go fight of someone in the ring, his life has meaning again. So I'm sure that can have some serious negative consequences, because if you follow Fury, he was really excited for the Wilder fight. So sure, the fighters do lose, but at the end of the day, the fans lose the most, because we miss out on the fights that we're always looking to see. And this can lead to boxing dying way quicker than it is, or it's the leading cause of the death of the sport, in my opinion, because people eventually just get fed up with it. I'm tired of watching, no offense to other boxers, but nobody's fighting nobody. Because let's be real, the casual person doesn't really care about up and comers. A lot of casuals really just kind of be like, oh, I want the big names in the sport to fight each other. And it really, the who are the big names? They're the names that everybody can recognize. Naoya Inoue is one of my favorite fighters, but ask pretty like any casual, I'm sure very few people will actually know who he is. So they just want to see the people that are plastered all over, people like Ryan Garcia, Manny Pacquiao, Floyd Mayweather, Tyson Fury, Anthony Joshua, Deontay Wilder. They want to see those guys fight each other, right? And we're not getting these fights at all due to shitty politics. And then they go, well, screw this, I'm going to UFC because I can watch Conor McGregor fight Dustin Poirier because that's what I want to see, and it'll actually happen. And so it's not even, and then boxing loses respect as a sport because of it. And it's not even the fighter's fault, it's the fault of the shitty politics and management behind the sport. And it upsets me because there's not a whole lot that can be done unless us as fans really push these organizations to give us these super fights and maybe push to simplify the sport of boxing a little bit. Let's try and get one governing body to really help unify the three belts or the three organizations. Let's have a governing body that acts over top of them. We don't have to get rid of them completely, but we need some form of better organization. And the only way we're ever going to get that is if the fans continue to push for better organization. Otherwise, just like I said in my Jake Paul Triller video, they're going to keep doing it because it's still making the money. And it's either going to lead to a sport that nobody cares about anymore, which is starting to happen already, and eventually boxing just going to die and be seen as a joke, or we're just gonna keep getting mediocre fights with shitty politics. It's either gonna keep going like this, or the sport is just going to die, and no one is going to care. And so the point of this video is just to me talk about, is just for me to talk about the side of boxing that people often overlook, and what you can do to help both the fans and the fighters. If you want to help, start voicing stuff like this. Start supporting people who are making an effort to simplify, or not even simplify, but better organize the sport. Because without better organization, I truly do believe that eventually boxing is going to die, and that is a very, very tragic thing. But that is really all I have to say for this video. Until next time, I'm not dead yet, and if you aren't either, there is always a tomorrow waiting for you. Boxing's not dead yet. Let's work together and fight for the tomorrow of boxing.